the fine folks at ClearSonic have asked me to say a few words about this thing right here. It's a baffle, and why I use it. The history of the baffle, it started up about 10 years ago, where, like most guitar players, always was told to turn down. You're too loud, you're too loud, you're too loud. And when you'd step in front, when I would step in front of the amp, I would notice there's a beam, like a really harsh beam. It would be very bright and brittle and somewhat displeasing to the ear, mostly to your fans. And I ordered a ClearSonic baffle that was very small. It was the size of a Fender Twin or a combo amp. And basically would stack boxes around it and make the baffle. And my friend Jim Moody built the first prototypes of these, which are now built by ClearSonic, about 6 years ago for a gig that I was doing. I said, I need a baffle. So he stumbled upon the secret blend of herbs and spices and the measurements that actually make this work. So I love it. We use it to really as a beam blocker, and it allows the guitar to be turned up to a point where the amp's working and the speakers are working, and you get that reaction of an amp that's kind of on 10 without killing your front row and without having your sound man quit on you on a night-to-night basis. So, and the guitar is able to get in the mains as well. Now the question is like, well, geez, I don't know if it's going to sound too dull, if it's going to sound too, you know, whatever. I'm not sure. I'm used to my amp kind of going this way. You know, I started doing it with the same kind of trepidation, but as I got used to it and I was able to really kind of refine where I put it and how I put it, I set it in kind of an M or a W depending on how you're looking at it. I really have come to where I can't live without it. I can do a show with any combination of amps and guitars. If I don't have a baffle, I'm like really in trouble. So, and the ClearSonic people are nice enough now where they make them for me. As we go through them, and you do go through them. They're you know, a couple hundred dates a year. They get scuffed up and scratched, but generally they're very, very reliable. And we travel all over the world, so that's the reason why I use the baffle. And again, it's something that's not for everybody. But if you're playing live consistently, and you have people in your front row, and you're consistently being told to turn down. This will solve a lot of your problems, and you'll be a lot happier with your onstage tone, and you'll be happier with your feel of the guitar, and it's one of those things where, nothing ventured, nothing gained. So, thank you guys for coming out here and talking about the